Donald Trump says he's presiding over an economic miracle. Don't believe the hype. Recently, there's been some good news about the economy overall. In the second quarter of 2018, gross domestic product, or GDP, grew at a robust 4.1% annual rate. It's a number you'll hear a lot from Trump and Republicans between now and November 6th. But GDP growth is a measure of the aggregate economy. People, on the other hand, experience the economy as individuals. Other economic indicators reveal why, while the overall economy appears healthy, many people are falling further behind. Here are three economic statistics every voter should know. Negative 9.7%. That's the change in real wages for workers since 2006. Real wages are your actual wages adjusted for inflation. Since things always get more expensive, it's not enough for wages just to go up to get ahead. They need to go up faster than inflation. Payscale's data shows that real wages are going down even after Trump passed his massive tax cut in late 2017. That's particularly remarkable considering Trump's advisors promised that wages would increase by $4,000 per family as a result of the cuts. Official government data, which measures inflation a little bit differently, is slightly more optimistic. It shows wages flat since the Trump tax cut, but the overall picture is still bleak. The economy is growing, but workers are not reaping the benefits. So if the economy is growing and wages are falling or flat, where is the money going? That leads us to our next statistic, $437 billion. That's how much corporations are spending to buy back their own stocks in the second quarter of 2018. Stock buybacks are a way for companies to boost their share prices. It helps investors and executives who are compensated by stock, but few others. $437 billion in buybacks in one quarter is an all-time record. The previous record? It was set in the first quarter of 2018, $242 billion. There's one group of people that is seeing wage increases, however, which brings us to our last statistic, 13,940,000. That's the average salary of a CEO at the 500 largest publicly traded companies. That's 361 times higher than the average worker, who made $38,613. In many companies, the ratio is even worse. The CEO of Mattel made $31 million last year, almost 5,000 times more than Mattel's average worker. In the 1950s, the average CEO made 20 times the average worker. So remember, the economic statistics you see in the headlines don't necessarily reflect the reality for the average worker. To figure that out, you have to dig just a little bit deeper.
But we have the greatest economy in the history of our country. We have things that have never happened before.